Condemnation to hell is only for the Lord God. Now, there are preachers out there that are saying, you're going straight to hell. You're going to hell. That's not their place. They should say what the Bible says. And the Bible makes us to know while we're living, you are going to go to hell if you don't. So on, so on, so on. But for us to say, oh, they going to hell, they going to drop straight into hell and all this other stuff, this is not biblical. Everybody that's breathing has a chance to repent, accept Jesus Christ into their heart, have a Holy Ghost life, and do these things. Unfortunately, most people aren't going to do that and are going to end up in hell. But if they don't accept the gospel. So this is the truth. So we also want to give you just a couple examples of everyday judgment that all y'all do and you don't think about it. And in your hypocrisy, you just heard what just a few of the scriptures said about judges. It's not wrong. You just got to make sure you ain't into what you trying to judge. You hear about these judges on the bench sentencing pedophiles to prison, and they up there doing the same thing, but it got exposed. You hear about people like people like Jamal Bryan up there trying to talk about God and talk about why you should believe in God and all this other stuff. And he walk around sleeping with 17-year-old girls, and he's supposed to be married. This is the type of thing. But God is going to expose that. Many of you, you don't even walk across an intersection without making determination. Again, judgment is simply a determination. When a jury says we find the defendant in this matter guilty, that is a determination. Judgment is simply determination. You can't even walk across a busy intersection without determining or judging. Okay, the light is green. I'm gonna look left. I'm gonna look right. No cars are coming. It's safe. When you say it's safe to walk around the street, it may seem elementary, but that is judgment. You are judging. You see kids do right or kids do wrong. You see people doing right and wrong, and whether you voice it or think it, you be like, oh man, that ain't right. Or if they're your kids, prayerfully, you'll correct them, or oh, little heathen's going to end up in prison. This is what's going to happen. So if you see your kids doing wrong, you correct them, don't you? And how do you correct them? What measure do you use to correct your children? You use the measure of what you believe is right and what you believe is wrong. That is judgment. You review your kid's report card. Many of y'all think, oh my God, my kid's struggling in school. You ain't been a one parent teacher conference. You don't know nothing. You just look at their report card and determine they're not doing well in school. You judge what your child is doing in school by their report card. That is judgment. You don't even apply for jobs you don't have the skill for unless because you determine you don't have the skill set or the money ain't right or whatever measure that is that you use to judge. You judge every day of your life. And also, you can't even balance your checkbook without determining what's coming in and what's going out, or you start bouncing checks, everyday things. You don't want your kids to do drugs. Hopefully some of you heathens going straight to hell because you're smoking drugs with your kids. Y'all need to repent and believe the gospel, or you're going to drop straight into hell if you don't repent and believe the gospel. Most of y'all don't want your kids involved with drugs. You don't want your kids involved with gang. You don't want your kids on pornography sites. You don't want all of these things from your kids. Why? Because you've judged that those things are no good for your kids. Now, if you in church, you ought to say, this is what the books say. But you judge every day of your life. And many of y'all have missed life-changing moments because you are being a religious hypocrite by saying you can't judge nobody when this is not what the book teaches. This is not what the book teaches. And I'm going to smack y'all over the head. I'm going to smack y'all straight over the head with something else, if you don't mind, and which is simply this, and it's my second point. Your motives for judgment will determine the effectiveness of your judgment. Again, we go back to the people that were going to stone the woman and Jesus. They were going to kill her, not give her. She just done. They were going to break her, bust her head. They were going to bust her head down to the white meat, you heard. But she was done. And if they would have done that, she never would have had a chance to repent And she would have never had a chance to even speak and meet Jesus. She wouldn't have had that conversation with Jesus. But Jesus' judgment was more effective because he corrected her, gave her the opportunity, as God does you every day, that you walking around in your sin. But his judgment is not going to linger forever. And he's going to come down and judge you. He is going to do it. He's going to expose you. So again, the motives for your judgment will determine the effectiveness of your judgment. Y'all need to stop trying to put people down just because you don't like them. You don't really see nothing wrong with what they're doing. You just don't like them. And this is sin. This causes sin in your life, sin in your family's life. Even when you're mumbling and grumbling, you have to understand that you cannot judge the judgment of condemnation. Because again, if you don't pull the beam out of your eye on issues, you're not going to be able to see clearly to pull it out of your neighbors. Most of y'all get mad when somebody cut y'all off in traffic. Y'all say, that's against the law. Where the police at? And all this other stuff. So, no, you judge every day is all that I am simply saying. So don't be a hypocrite and say people you can't judge. Let me ask you something. The people who raised you up, if you're older, Big Mama ain't at home no more. But if you are older, if you remember the people who meant most to you in your life, who was it, your mama, your grandmama, whoever that was, did they not judge you? Did they not tear your tail up? Did they not scold you? Did they not say stuff to you that corrected you and sent you down the right path? But no, you can't judge nobody. This is what you say, and you wouldn't even made it to adulthood if somebody wouldn't have loved your stank tail enough to judge you. So my question is, this is just a bunch of foolishness. These people don't want accountability again. And this is why the churches are watered down. This is why we have all these churches in all these cities, on all these blocks, on all these corners, and all these denominations, and we still have all this mess because nobody wants to be held accountable. People don't believe in church discipline anymore. And spineless pastors will sit back and say, oh, I got to pray for them. Well, yeah, you got to pray for them, but the book tells you how to handle church discipline. The book gives you the power to judge the righteous judgment, and this is what you need to do. I'm going to give you some more if you don't mind right quick. I'm going to go to the 7th chapter of John, and I'm going to go start at the 21st verse. Jesus answered and said unto them, I have done work and you all marvel. Moses therefore gave unto you the circumcision. This is what it says. Not because it is of Moses, but of the fathers. And ye are on the Sabbath day circumcised a man. If a man on the Sabbath day receives circumcision, that the law of Moses should not be broken, are you angry at me because I've made a man ever withhold on the Sabbath? Judge not according to appearance, but judge the righteous judgment. Again, Jesus is telling some religious hypocrites that they should judge the righteous judgment. So how is it then that you say you ain't supposed to judge nobody? Do y'all see how foolish this is? Even that thing which is called the Great Commission, which is illustrated out in the 28th chapter in the book of Matthew, is so-called the Great Commission, but it is judgment. It's judgment, y'all. Can't y'all see how easy this is? Don't y'all want to get spiritually well? Don't y'all want y'all stole souls to stay out of hell? If you do, you would love this word here. So we're going to, the 28th chapter of Matthew is called, this is when Jesus sent his disciples out, which after, and I'm going to tell you something, after he sent them from being disciples, then they became apostles, and apostles are sent ones, essentially church planters. You got apostles sitting up under pastors, and that just ain't biblical. Again, backslid and watered down churches don't want to speak the truth unto them. And check this out. And I'm going to start reading at the 18th verse of the 28th chapter of Matthew. Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things which I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. That in itself is judgment. If I'm going to go into all the world and preach the gospel, I first have to believe that the world needs, or I have to determine that the world needs what it is that I am going to tell them according to the word Jesus. And then I'm going to have to baptize them, which means I believe they were spiritually dead, right? If they spiritually dead, why are they going to go down the water and be baptized? This is because you've made a determination. You make determinations every day of your life in the simplest matters. But when it comes to the house of God, when it comes to the things of God, you don't want to talk about that stuff. And it's because you are comfortable in your sins. It is because you are backslid, you're a reprobate mind. It's because you've been let off the hook and somebody ain't teaching you about the real Jesus, the real Bible, and the real salvation. Somebody isn't teaching you about the power that we have to keep order in the church, in our homes, and in our lives, judging the righteous judgment. This is because jackleg pastors want you to be comfortable, and they don't want to tell you the truth. They don't want you to be offended, and they don't want you to run out the door. This is the truth. And they don't want you to run out the door, essentially, because, oh, I need more time with them. The Negroes don't know if you got more time. You could be dead tomorrow, and here they is watering down the church today. This is because they don't love you. Nobody that loves you, like your mama when she told your tail up, like your parents or your grandmama when they corrected you, a teacher, a coach who was hard on you, and you still remember them to this day. Nobody that loves you is going to withhold the truth from you so you can be comfortable where you're at. Stop lying on Jesus. Hey, Doc, stop lying on Jesus is the name of the series. Stop lying on Jesus, y'all. Stop. He didn't tell y'all to not judge. He taught you how to judge. But the first thing y'all need to do is repent and get saved. The first thing y'all need is to believe on the name of Jesus. You backsliding church members, y'all need to come on back and try to get the Holy Ghost and ask the Lord for the Holy Ghost. Not like those false prophets like Juanita Bynum, and all this other foolishness. That's not the Lord. That's a demon. That's what that is. So stop saying you can't judge me. You're never going to be. You first ain't going to get saved if you don't first determine that you're in need of a Savior. You judge every day. Religious hypocrites, repent. Negro church members, repent. You cowardly and spineless pastors who sit up there, our Father, not God, the Father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Y'all need to quit that foolishness and repent, you cowards. You're ashamed of the gospel. This is why you don't tell people this. You don't love them. If you love them, you tell them the truth. So be it.